No, no. Whoops. Okay. No starting soon because this thing is starting in 6 minutes. I just finished cooking dinner. I haven't eaten dinner. I just finished cooking dinner. And I've only been up for what, 2 hours ish? I've only been up for like 2 hours. I sound more awake than I did in that recording for the Nintendo Direct. Which, that is up. That is up, by the way. I wasn't going to wake myself up at 10 a.m. for Nintendo. I'm okay with streaming Sony at 6 p.m. because that's a much more reasonable time. And if I did stream the Nintendo Direct at 10 a.m., I would have fucking ended the recording, just gone, or ended the stream and be like, fucking God, fuck off. That would be my entire reaction. Considering my reaction to the Nintendo Direct is pretty lackluster, and this comes from a person who isn't a giant like, oh my God, bing wahoo, or a person who's like, oh my God, what's with all these JRPGs? Because I like JRPGs. It's always, oh, God damn it. I shouldn't have ate those pickens. This comes from a person who's like, actually likes JRPGs. But yeah, I'm going to do this. We are doing this. Which the only thing I'm looking forward to is goddamn Final Fantasy 16 is if it's here. Let me be honest. Nintendo Direct, it's like, that's about it. You show me that, I'll be more excited than I was watching that Nintendo Direct. Fucking 20 seconds of Tears of the Kingdom. That's what it's now called. For Zelda. I'm like, wow, 20 seconds? And a release date of May. So that's when the Switch 2 is coming, right? Because, yeah. Man. Hello, Willison. Gonna do this short stream of this just because. Any predictions? Final Fantasy 16 is the only thing that I can think of that will probably be here. They might show off that God of War 2. It said a couple of PSVR 2 stuff, so maybe a price tag for that, because I know that's supposed to be like early 2023. Maybe RE8 and VR like they teased. Forspoken would be a big thing, it'll be terrible. Okay, yeah, no, well, number one, yeah, Forspoken will be terrible. The thing to kind of remember is that TGS is this week, the Tokyo Game Show. So I would kind of like how the Nintendo Direct had a lot of like a few Square Enix games because they're showing those off at TGS. I feel like Sony, that like, yeah, Forspoken will probably be there as well. Just because that's coming out in February? Man, Forspoken was supposed to come out like next month, if I remember correctly. Yeah, my only hope is Final Fantasy 16, because I believe in Yoshi P. Ugh. Yeah, never before I've seen so big budget games have so little hype. It's weird because, like, it's one of the games that Amy Hennig helped write, but also it has, like, I think the problem is the other guy who's writing it. I forget what his name is. It's being done by the Luminous team, which is the Final Fantasy 15 team. And it's just like, oh, it's an isekai, but like every single piece of dialogue has been so off-putting that like it doesn't help. Other than that, like I'm actually kind of interested in just PSVR2 stuff. I kind of like VR stuff. Like, I do have both a kind of relatively cheap VR headset for my PC as well as a headset for the PS4. And my only hope is that because of how the PSVR 2 is designed, you could use that headset on the PC. Because all it requires is like a couple of USBs. One of them USB-C and a USB-A. Because that's what's on front of the PS5. Yo, Tekken! We're just going into Tekken, never fucking mind! Wow, already I am more hype about this than I was the fucking, Nintendo stuff, because it didn't have Tekken! I mean, Nintendo started out with, like, Fire Emblem, but, like, I feel like I'm Fire Emblemed out. So Street Fighter 6, because usually they might tease another character. I mean, we already know what characters are in that game, but like, because of leaks, but some of that is actually gameplay. Some of that is actually fucking gameplay. Even if you look at like what Street Fighter 6 is doing.
It's official. Tekken 8 is coming to the PlayStation 5 console courtesy of our battle-hardened friends at Bandai Namco Entertainment.
Considering how even Tekken 7 looks and how Street Fighter 6 is currently looking.
Now, let's check in on two games in development for PlayStation VR 2.
That I can believe on like the current systems. Yeah, that's definitely it. Wow, Star Wars VR.
Tech who had no business getting into this kind of trouble, but there they were, standing against evil wherever it popped up.
Now, when it cuts to like specific moments within that fight, I would believe that's part of a cutscene. But like, just the animations alone kind of remind me, yeah, that's probably gameplay. Or at very least, it's in-engine. It got no sounds? Oh yeah, I don't have sounds on. I didn't start up the bot.
Hello, my friend.
Starting up the bot now means that y'all won't get, I would have this. Turn off OBS and stop the stream. I only had like 6 minutes to get ready from making dinner. So
ready for battle. Let all monsters beware.
I should disable all the sounds or something. I should re-edit that. Actually, fuck, I forgot to even edit the stream, didn't I? Hold on. I was just trying to go straight from one thing to another. I am so ill prepared. I don't care what's going on right now. So, edit, Sony thing. There, it's all edited.
Demio brings the creativity and chaos.
Hello, Spencer.
Of a tabletop RPG.
I forgot that to change all my shit.
This next game is being rebuilt from the ground up and will be available outside of Japan for the first time.
Wow, that could be anything. Like, from Sega, that could be anything. That could be a Soccer Wars. Wait, what if this is Ishin? Or Kezen? This is Kezen. This is those Yakuza games that we didn't get. I can just tell this is the Dragon Engine. Fuck you! This is better than Nintendo's shit!
Sakamoto.
Yep. Holy fuck! Yo! Yo, we're just getting them. We're just getting them. Thank fucking God. Pandemonium had to go through a goddamn fan translation. Never mind, we're just going to get these motherfucking games. Holy fuck. This is more exciting than I was during the fucking direct. You can go see the upload on YouTube. Ishin, like a dragon. Okay, we're just dropping the Yakuza. Makes sense, like a dragon, Ishin, February. Yo, okay, cool. That means we're probably gonna get Kezen after this. God damn. God damn.
Hello, Madam Mason. I understand you have a shop to sell.
I think you will find my terms quite
ingenious. What's that one's half bad? Yeah,
what's
well, it's fucking Yakuza.
You
I like a dragon and Ryugaku Koto.
Why is your mistress selling the shop?
She has had rotten bad luck with the last few tenants.
But, I mean, this I don't care because it's Harry Potter.
Those who came before you just could not seem to escape the darkness.
Maybe? I don't know. Wait, no, this maybe isn't. Fuck. I just hear British and witches and like that, and I just think, oh, it's, oh no, it is Hogwarts. Never mind. Okay, never mind. I don't care. The Haunting Hogsmeade shop exclusive PS trip quadruple DL content. Okay. I don't know what this is. Days gone too. No, I don't think so. Nah, that's too stylized to be that. Never mind. I just hear like something like Pacific Northwest and I'm just like, days gone. Days Gone is a game. I would never stream Days Gone because it's too big of a game. Hello, Freedom. Yeah, that's those sounds. I'm sorry. I didn't put that on the bot. Locations impacted include sectors Delta and Echo. Okay, all I know about this game is that you drive through storms. But weird things happen?
Another one? After all these years?
Okay.
Call her. Now.
Why did the car disappear? Okay, in the game. Pacific, like, you drive through the Pacific Northwest. Weird shit happens.
Survive a ride from hell in Pacific Drive, the debut game from Ironwood Studio. Up next, let's check in on PlayStation Stars, a loyalty program rolling out soon.
I don't give a flying fuck. Loyalty programs suck.
Hi, everyone. I'm Grace.
It's time for me to go to sleep.
Not long ago, we announced a brand new loyalty program called PlayStation Stars. It's designed to celebrate you, the players. It will be free to join PlayStation Stars. As a member, you can complete various activities to earn points that can be redeemed for rewards. Digital collectibles
just
are a
avatars,
highlight of the program.
Probably.
These are digital representations of things that PlayStation fans love.
Wow,
today,
avatars.
I'm pleased to give you a sneak peek at some examples of our digital collectibles.
Ape
Whether
Escape,
it's a
remember
game
Ape Escape? We're never bringing back an Ape Escape. There's a fat PS3.
Something new to collect.
There's those weird little cats that are Japan only. Hey, remember that? Yo, it's
and
Polygon,
I have
man.
More good news. PlayStation Stars will begin to roll out in some regions in Asia starting in late September. It will launch in the Americas and Europe in the weeks that follow. That's it for now. Check PlayStation Blog to learn more about PlayStation Stars.
Cool, at least that was only like 45 seconds. Insufficient advanced technology is indistinguishable from magic. Yeah, you know what? That's a pretty good quote. If you see how fucking thin my TV is, you would just go, man, that shit's magic. Not actual gameplay, no fucking shit.
おはようございます。今日もしっかりと稼ぎましょう。AO再掘ポイントを近いです。これはレアサイズのものです。高熱源体接近、データベースにない新種のエンダーズと思われます。所属不明機よりロックオン、緊急迎撃システム起動。
強敵ではありますが、我々の本気を見せてあげま。高エネルギー反応、対象から攻撃、来ます。Would you like to have an AI waifu that helps you pilot your mech? You know, that just kind of reminds me that we haven't seen anything from that Capcom game in a while.
PS5 console
exclusive. Oh, I'm a lizard. You never make me
a
lizard.
Let's take a look.
What? I don't make any frog sounds either. God damn. Is this God of... No, it's not God of Boy. It's like, wait, did somebody actually name their studio a studio name, but then this is the second EVE studio? Oh, wait, no, this is that other game that we saw like last year. That was like another like Bayonetta type game.
Ani. 이곳의 주민들은 에너지 고갈로 잠들어 있는 거야. 이대로 간다면 영원한 어둠뿐이지. 이브.
Because I remember her.
우리를 도와줘.
I remember her. I'm pretty sure this is the Korean game. Stella Blade. Yeah, that is Korean. Huh. That just means it's coming to the PC as well. Anytime you see console exclusive, it means that it's coming to PC. Same thing with, like, every time they do that for, like, an Xbox game. That's why the Xbox actually has no games. It's all PC. Gross. There's a booger. What?
After 3 centuries of the Tokugawa's repressive rule, the black ships.
Like, I'm pretty sure this is also another,
began to tear itself apart.
Wait. Those is this Way of the Samurai? The past,
those who embrace the new. And
is Tecmo Koei making another Way of the Samurai game?
Masters and bonds.
Because usually, like, any game that takes place in
I will watch over you all,
like that late 1800s, but also you see British people in Japan. That always seems to be the same series of games.
Your time has come. Rise as one.
No? Rise of the Ronin. Huh. Or was Way of the Samurai a different game? 2024? That's 2 years from now. Jesus. Or a year and a half.
Experience an era of great change and upheaval in Rise of the Ronin, a sprawling action RPG from Team Ninja. Before we wrap up, we've got one more update for you.
Okay, time for God of Boy. God of Boy 2. You know, funnily enough, I did eventually play God of War, like, last year. Didn't stream it, I just played it in my off hours. Wow, a controller! Not even gameplay footage, just a fucking DualSense controller! Holy fucking shit, everybody! Are you so excited for the last announcement to be a DualSense controller?
Everyone keeps secrets.
Now here's the game.
Sometimes it's the only way to protect the ones we love.
But yeah, it was a pretty fine game. I did. It's fine. I didn't think it's. I don't think it's an amazing game, but like.
God Killer.
What is it you want from me? Is it a God of War you came to find?
You don't really want war.
They said the name.
Kratos.
Technically, they said, "Is it the God of War?" And I clap. Did you clap? I'm clapping now. They said the name of the title.
I can't talk about it, but I just need you to trust me.
If
follow your every whim.
But you don't believe in any of it.
And still, I follow. Because all that matters is that you are safe.
But that's not all that matters. Who's keeping you safe?
I do not need you to protect me.
You sure about that?
Pretender God! For the old father!
Death can have me when it earns me.
Why is it that every God of War game needs Kratos to climb out of hell? Like, it happens in every game, right? Clapping with no hands, shut up.
Ever prayed to you? Can you even imagine that kind of love? No!
You don't care about anything beyond yourself. Beyond the monster who kills without cause.
Fate only binds you if you let it. Do what is necessary.
Well, that's hot.
Not because it is written.
Oh, look, it's Thor. He's fucking fat.
We make our own destiny.
But the strong kind of fat. You know, I never played God of War 3.
God of War Ragnarok.
Well, I've played it, but like I've never like gotten past like the first like 30 minutes. Oh well. Acrophatic, strong fat, like the body build, the actual type of strong fat that like actually having muscles is like, but like everybody thinks about bodybuilders, but like that's like starving themselves to get that certain sheen. That's not really actual like strongness. Shorter than the Nintendo Direct, but it had Isshin. So I actually had excitement. Unlike the Nintendo Direct of, we learn Pikmin 4 is finally happening. Yay. Remember the fact that 6 years ago Miyamoto said Pikmin 4 was almost done? Well, guess what? Now it's almost done. Here's a new Fire Emblem. Oh, hey, it's like I could watch Vinny. Also, no Liberty Mutual. No. People also watch Nintendo Direct. If you want to see my reaction to my Nintendo, wait, no, ignore. If you want to see my reaction to that Nintendo Direct, I cannot go to my own channel, can I? Fuck. I cannot go to my own channel. But hey! Ryu got Gokuto Isshin! More people watching that! But yeah, maybe I can do that. Maybe if I do Xavier, if I type in my name. If you want to see my reaction to the Nintendo Direct, oh wait, I probably have to put in VT, don't I? VT. Oh. I don't know how to search for myself. I don't get excited on trailer. I get excited for more. A fucking re-release of a game that we never got here, of a series that I really enjoy. So yeah, I get excited about that. Huh, can I not even search myself? I can't even search my my videos on my own channel unless I follow my channel. Fuck. All right. Oh well. Anyways, tonight's Pokemon Coliseum doesn't exist. I do exist. You know what? Fuck it. I'll link the Oh wait, no, I can't link the Twitter because I don't have the bot active. Fuck. Oh, not Twitter. YouTube. Don't have the bot active. Fuck me. Fuck me in my ass. Anyways, I'll see you guys tonight for Pokemon Coliseum. I get to. You know what? Let's see. I'm throwing you guys over to. Fuck it. I'm throwing you guys over to Dev. You can go watch him watch the Nintendo Direct / raid game boomers, and this way you can't do that. This channel has follower or subscriber only chat. Wow, why don't you tell Dev to go kiss my fucking ass because of that? It tells me that. All right, I'll see y'all later.